appreciate y'all so much. You see in the pictures, we've got about 19 and a half acres there. We're blessed. It seems, looking at it, like it's a very peaceful place. It's not. It's a very restless place, as they're trying to overcome. And it's very difficult to overcome. We just thank you so much for the help. And God has given an increase. At this time, we're going to be asking several men to come up, those who have completed, well, 1 4-year and 2 18-month and 2 3 1-year certificates to briefly give thanks. Thanks to God, for one, after they receive their certificate. Thanks to everyone here, you all. At first, I want to ask Jason Cable to come up and his brother Patrick. Patrick is going to speak in the place of Jason. But what we have for Jason is really not a certificate. He's been there, like Charles said, from the beginning. But we got him something a little extra. We got him a gift card at Texas Longwood.
He can take care of you no matter what situation you're in or anything. But And to have, actually have a close relationship with my family again is just amazing. But thank you all for everything you've done, support everybody.
About God's rescue, and he said they had a pond full of catfish and a wood. Christian brothers and sisters. Thank you.
Glenn was 1 year, Bo was, and Christopher Ryan. Come on up, Christopher, 1 year. That's a good year. Back to God, according to James 5:19-20. present if someone turns away to the, from the truth, or from the truth, let him know that he who converted the sinner from the error of his way shall save a soul from death. And brethren, that's what we're doing. Saving souls from death. We're not just trying to get them off of alcohol and drugs. It's all about getting to heaven. That's why we're Bible-based and church-focused. Since about 160 men have come our way to Project Rescue in the last some 4 years, and altogether 66 of them are continuing. So we have a 41, it stays right around the list, between 39 and 42% our success rate, which doesn't seem very good. But we are twice as much as the best secular programs, and they're good programs, but they're not biblical. And the reason we're twice as much as the secular programs, our success rate is because of that. It's because of the Word of God. We have so much help, we can't do it without you. We can't do it with all the help. I know already we mentioned the management team, Cecil, Joe, and Ray. If it wasn't for the management team, there would be no Project Rescue today. Charles and I had a rough go in the beginning, and we needed their help. We survived each other. But they helped us so much, and we appreciate the management team. Charles and I both do, because they've helped us so much. Cecil over here on the side of Charles is really the president, but he's on the ground management, and we're killing Cecil. He's going on vacation. I just hope Patsy bring him back. Stay away. He's going on vacation tomorrow. Of course, Charles come into help with intake recently. And he's saving us. I know he's saving me and Jay. Charles does so much more, too, than that on the ground with the men. Mentioned Jason already. He's our night manager. Bo the day manager. Why would we be able to do manage the program without you? You see the picture up once in a while with Roger and Paul Martin. Roger Jackson's our Bible teacher. What he does, and he does it right from the beginning when they get there, when their brains are still half asleep and they're in withdrawals, he'll be studying. He studies hermeneutics, just basic hermeneutics. We don't care if it's a preacher, an elder, son, who. They start off with basic hermeneutics, according to Hebrews 5, going back to those basic principles. But appreciate Robin. Roger studies. He preaches somewhere else. I forget the name of it, but that's why he's not here tonight. But he studies one-on-one for about 45 minutes with about seven guys a day. I don't know how he does it. Paul and Wayne Speak will come out on Monday night. And Caleb Cunningham, the preacher for the Christ-Little Church of Christ, has started coming out on Tuesdays. And Kim, our nurse, and Jamie, I'd be dead without Jamie. There'd be no program. My wife, so thankful to her so much. We appreciate it. We know we've gone over a little bit. I tried to make you know as fast as I could there. But we appreciate this place. You know, we're involved in what you could term as from 2 Corinthians chapter 5, the ministry of reconciliation. It talks about now Paul would say how he had been given the word of reconciliation. We have that same word. He was given the ministry of reconciliation. And the first thing, the best thing is what you see there, souls being baptized into Christ and winning souls back to the Lord. That is reconciling souls to God. That's our main work. It's amazing sitting and watching a man who's been out of the worship for 5 years to come and sit in a worship service. It's amazing. And then to see him grow. So, and then, as you can see from the pictures with their children, and that link with the ministry of reconciliation, too. And it's amazing to see fathers who have not been away from their children, from their wives, and to see them reconciled. It's really a privilege for all of us to be involved in this work. Now, at this time, we're really blessed because Ray Sally is going to come up and close us out in song.
We're just going to sing one song. We're going to sing it by heart. We're going to sing Leaning on the Everlasting Arms. Joe Drake will then come and lead us in our closing prayer. Let us stand, please.